Hey guys, this is Anna from TenWeb, a managed WordPress hosting powered by Google Cloud. In this video, we will talk about choosing the best possible shared WordPress hosting platform, or maybe eventually not even choosing one. This is how the conversation will go. First, we'll talk a little about what a shared hosting is, its main advantages and disadvantages, and who the typical customers of a shared WordPress hosting are, and what you as a WordPress website owner should and need to expect from your hosting provider. Just so we're clear and realistic about the expectations that you can have with your shared hosting provider. After that, we'll talk about shared hosting and its place in the age of fast development of technologies. And then we'll discuss about the one alternative to shared hosting that you definitely do not know about. Then we will talk about the two main WordPress hosting type options that you have and leave it to you to make the educated decision. So let's get started. Oh, and by the way, down in the descriptions, you will find timestamps. So use them to skip to other parts of the video that you're more interested in. As you know, a website, and your website too, is a whole bunch of data that is stored on a server. Now, in case of shared hostings, it's like being a part of a big commune. That is, you share your space on the server with a bunch of other websites who are basically like your neighbors. But if in the case of a commune, you also get some benefits, for example, someone cooking a dinner and sharing it with you, or maybe helping you fix your sink. In case of shared hostings, all you get are mostly risks and no rewards at all. Here's why. The other websites that you're sharing your space with can and often have faulty securities. So if any of them gets hacked or compromised in some way, all the other websites on the same server are also at risk of being affected. Or a bad website may suddenly have a sudden surge of traffic coming to their website, and this may slow down all the other websites and their performance on the same server. Slowing down to a turtle speed is basically a very common complaint when it comes to website owners or managers that use shared hosting. Now, whenever you share a server with other websites, the speed of your website cannot be too fast, and the consistency of the uptime cannot be perfect as well, meaning that whenever a person visits your website, they may be tired of waiting for it to get fully loaded and just leave your website, or maybe someone might click on your URL and find that your website has been crashed. Everything is very disappointing. Let's not even mention how important your website speed is for Google rankings. Now, on top of the performance issues, there are also many extra efforts that you need to make for your shared hosting platform. For example, you will need to install a third-party caching service. You will need to pay additional money in order to purchase a SSL certificate in order to make the connections more secure. You will need to also install a staging plugin in order to test the changes before making them go live. Then you will also need to scan for vulnerabilities and malfunctioning plugins on your own from time to time. And most importantly, you will need to limit yourself within the resources that are provided to you by your shared hosting company. And this list goes on and on. In short, everyone is sure to agree that shared hostings can be a whole different headache for website owners in many ways. So you might be questioning yourself, why is it that people even eventually end up using shared hostings? What are the advantages of a shared hosting? The answer is pretty straightforward. The reason is that shared hostings are the cheapest possible hosting types that you can get for your WordPress websites. The prices usually range from $3 to $10 a month, and basically you can't get any WordPress hosting for any cheaper. These are the prices that usually people make those famous for the price of a Starbucks Frappuccino type of comments. This explains a lot, or used to explain a lot. Shared hostings are for the websites that usually college professors ask for their students to have for an online portfolio, and usually these types of websites have about a total of 3 readers, and they're the friends of the website owner, so they will continue reading the blog even if it crashes every once in a few days. Usually what would happen is that people would start off by using a shared WordPress hosting for their WordPress websites for a starting point, and then whenever they would make more money, they would switch to a better hosting type. So shared hosting has served humanity well. In fact, it uses the principle, start where you are and work your way up. Most of your favorite bloggers and influencers have started out by using a shared WordPress hosting somewhere back in the distant past, but they've moved on and are now using a better WordPress hosting platform. But let's be real here. You, a website owner or a blog owner, have an idea, and in order to realize this idea, you'll need a website. And in the perfect world, you need your website to A, be accessible all times and be very fast, B, you need it to have a simple and beautiful design and to be easily built, C, you want it to cover its own technical aspects and have all the features in order to do so, and D, you want it to handle your traffic and have enough storage space for your data. With shared hosting, you cannot expect any of those needs to be met. You can only cross your fingers and hope that one day you'll be able to make more money and afford a better WordPress hosting. But guess what? Technology in general and hosting technology in particular have developed so much that shared hosting platforms, even the best shared hosting, is not relevant anymore. With the growing popularity and the increasing accessibility of hosting on cloud, shared hostings are most probably on their way out. Soon, every website will have its own server to be hosted and its own IP address. So basically, the real revolution of shared hosting platforms are here. Now, every website owner, every WordPress website owner, and even the beginner ones will be able to have their needs fully met. How? TenWeb offers you a managed WordPress hosting, which means that you can host your site on a managed hosting that typically costs $30 a month for $10 per month. So basically, if you are a developer and need to host 10 or more websites, you will be able to do that for $6 a month per website. Now, this is something very disruptive in the market, and you can totally forget about the high costs of regular managed WordPress hostings and the low cost of shared hostings but low performances, because you'll be able to get a managed WordPress hosting at the price of a shared hosting. I have left you a link down in the description below so you can use it and test out TenWeb with the 14-day free trial available. Since the price of the best shared hosting and this unique managed WordPress hosting are basically the same, let's compare them based on the speed, security, features, and support, and see how is managed WordPress hosting better than the best shared hosting. Now, starting with the speed. So managed WordPress hosting powered by Google Cloud uses the state-of-the-art technologies, which ensures that your website is super fast and super reliable. So instead of being a small part of a huge commune, your website will have its own separate server and its own IP address, and basically it will be super fast and super secure and reliable. So many, many data centers work closely together in order to ensure that your website never goes down. Now that you have the whole speed issue all covered up, whenever you're focused on the SEO section of improving your website's performance, you can forget about the speed, which is basically something that people spend a lot of time and resources for improving. And not only will your visitors be satisfied whenever browsing your website, also they will be easier to convert to customers or readers, depending on what type of website yours is. In fact, if your website is either built with TenWeb or is migrated to the TenWeb hosting, you will be able to get a Google PageSpeed score of 95 plus automatically, and you can worry about the other aspects of managing your WordPress website. Number two is security. So hosting your site on Google Cloud automatically makes your website as secure as it can possibly get. And with the automatically generated 10 restore points by TenWeb, if anything ever surpasses the security service and damages your website, you will be able to easily restore these damages and bring back the original version of your website with only one click. Also, you will get an absolutely free SSL certificate, so your site will be able to establish secure and encrypted connections. Number three is features. The features that you get with TenWeb's managed hosting are just too many to count. Basically, whenever you choose TenWeb, you just do not need to worry about installing third-party softwares, but you can do it if you feel like it. Here's what you get. You get dozens of templates, designer-made templates that you can install with only one click and edit it completely using the most popular editor, which is Elementor, which is made even better with 10 webs widgets. You also get a backup service, an image optimizer, an SEO optimizer service, also a staging environment in order to test out all the changes before making them go live. You also get a gallery, a form maker, and any other WordPress software that basically comes to your mind. And all of this work perfectly together and come with all the plans absolutely for free. The next one is support. Sure, shared hostings also have support. However, most probably they are not going to be 24/7 and WordPress specific. Tenweb prides itself on being able to take on any WordPress related questions 24/7 via online chat. So if you have any type of questions or problems, the solutions and answers to them are only one online chat conversation away. So now that we've talked about the best shared WordPress hosting providers, and why you shouldn't choose them, you can make your educated choice. Just kidding. But really, their answer is pretty obvious. No more shared hosting. And no more bothering you with the difficult migrations from a shared hosting to a different host. But if you do decide to transfer your shared WordPress hosting to Tenweb, you will be able to do that with only one click. So there you go. If you are looking to watch more videos about WordPress and hosting and Tenweb, then like, subscribe, and comment, of course. Let's talk about making the best WordPress website out there.